writing in the newspaper called Black Westchester, which is primarily online. And one thing that I've noticed about Black Westchester is that more and more people are reading about our community through AJ's publication. We're finding that not only Mount Vernonites are reading about good, well-written journalism work, but people around the county are reading about what AJ is writing. So when you go to the rest of the county, you hear people saying, oh, but I read about it. And you think, oh, they must have read about it in the Journal News or someplace. But no, I read about it on Black Westchester. It's like, really? You read Black Westchester? I thought only us here in Mount Vernon read Black Westchester. But people are reading it, and then come to find out the Journal News reads Black Westchester to spread over some of their articles. So I said, you know what, in this day and age, in this new dot-com day and age where so many things are electronic these days, and you find that News 12 is losing reporters, and that the Journal News is losing reporters, and that print publication that we're so used to is fading. To have an entrepreneur like AJ and his team of people doing something different and providing a service to us to give us the news that we need, and very well-written news too, I said it's well-deserved to give AJ the award. So I'm going to read the resolution. Whereas AJ Woodson is the editor-in-chief of Black Westchester and co-owner of Urban Soul Media Group, the parent company, he's a father, author, writer, rapper, radio personality, hip-hop historian, and a freelance journalist whose byline has appeared in several print publications and online sites, including The Source, Vibe, The Village Voice, Upscale, SonicNet, Launch.com, Rollout Newspaper, Spiritual Minded Magazine, and several others. And whereas the son of Jerry Woodson of New Rochelle and Patricia Henderson of Mount Vernon, New York, A.J. Woodson was born in the city of Mount Vernon and spent his early years living on the second floor of 145 Washington Street in Mount Vernon. His grandfather was Leroy Fats Henderson, and his uncle was Kevin Clark, was a barber at Modernistic Barbershop on 3rd Street. His family moved to Central Islip, Long Island, when he was 7 years old. But his father moved back to Mount Vernon, but his parents got a divorce when A.J. was around the age of 12. As many children of divorce do, young A.J. blamed himself to Michaela, self-described rebel without a cause. His mom sent him back to Mount Vernon to live with his dad, which was a welcome development for him. Upon his return to Mount Vernon, A.J. enrolled in the 10th grade at Mount Vernon High School. And whereas when he graduated high school in 1986, A.J. Woodson returned to Long Island and teamed up with other hip-hop artists from the rap group JBC Force. JBC Force signed the independent hip-hop label B-Boy Records and released a single that put Long Island in the map as Strong Island, as it is still known in the hip-hop community today. As a hip-hop artist, A.J. Woodson toured the world and regularly interacted with legendary artists such as Red Alert, Salt-N-Pepa, Rakim, Queen Latifah, and many others. In the mid-1990s, A.J. moved back to Mount Vernon. By this time, he was doing public publicity and radio promotions for record companies and underground hip-hop artists. He also began interviewing notable personalities in the entertainment industry, personalities such as Nia Long, Vivica Fox, Pam Grier, Melvin, and Mario Van Peebles. Of his interview with legendary Muhammad Ali, A.J. Woodson said, to stand in his presence was incredible. And whereas, although he never studied journalism in school, A.J. Woodson has always been an avid reader and an avid writer. His writing career took off when a magazine had the idea to have one rapper review another rapper's CD. A.J. Woodson wrote the editorial and from there began writing for The Source, Vibe, Upscale, and several other hip-hop publications. His first piece of non-entertainment writing was triggered when he wrote a blog that eventually asked, if four black law enforcement officials can be held at gunpoint by white police officers in upstate New York, what chance does a regular guy like him have? And whereas A.J. Woodson subsequently teamed up with David K. Jones to create Black Westchester, an online magazine that seeks to uplift unsung heroes, change the narrative of how African Americans are portrayed in media, and to hold the feet of black officials to the fire. A.J. Woodson is also the father of one daughter, Paula Woodson, who, like her father, also tells stories stories and chronicles life, but does so through pictures and video. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the City Council, on behalf of the citizens of Mount Vernon, proudly honors AJ Woodson for creating, maintaining, and fostering Black-owned media outlets and for the vital role he plays in keeping the community well-informed here in the great city of Mount Vernon. AJ, congratulations.
Certificate of recognition to you and Black Lusters Magazine. Again, congratulations.
Thank you.